recall spirit.
Hey there.
Welcome back.
Yes?
You pain in the butt.
What?
Just welcoming back the pain in the butt. You know how it is. So we're out of critical? I guess so. But we had one left. Oh, we do have moderate. Or medium, rather. But she was out of that. Okay. Let's hope we can get her stuff.
Aye, yes.
Okay.
I avoid temptation unless I can't resist.
Okay, where's your stuff?
It's upright.
It's a pirate's, it's a right. This I was saving just in case. So hold on to that. I see wear on your head. Kinda weird. This is the displacement. What's this again? Well, that makes her go really fast. Okay, got all the stuff. I still gotta identify that. We used a lot of potions in that last battle. Two stacks like that. So we have three there, five there.
Yes.
That was a pretty crazy battle.
You what?
Yes.
Leading our way across. Oh god. We can't even be near the things. I'll get away from their flaming fist mercenary. If I were you. What happened? I died? Why? Thank you. killed someone. Oh! That's when Cyric, is it? Killed Bhaal? Must be. And then his blood poisoned the winding river. Look, she's coming around. Yeah.
You feel it, do you not? Something has changed. Your tenuous connection to the essence within you has been rewoven and reinforced, if not necessarily refined. An impressive achievement. Even if you yet lack the control necessary to bring your abilities to their full flower.
Alright, so we wake up with the Bhaal insignia around us, and then we got the hooded man talking to us. You again. What is your role in all this, hooded one? What do you hope to accomplish?
I am here to bear witness to what comes to pass, nothing more.
How delightful.
A dead god's blood lingers long. There are remnants of your father's power here, even now. I am not surprised something was awoken within you.
Okay.
Tell me, what did you see?
Yeah, I was right. But I have no idea who this guy is. So, to be... He wants answers. But we get nothing from him. So... I can't see why I would be so magnanimous as to give him all these details. You can't seriously expect me to relate the details of a near-religious epiphany to a stranger?
I am not your enemy. For now, our paths are intertwined and follow the same course. You need not fear me.
Who said anything about fearing you?
Bhaal had many enemies. Knowing this did not empower him to the extent that he could avoid his demise. But it did allow him to plan for it.
Right, by seeding the world with his Bhaal spawn.
He lives on through you and your brethren. You sense his whispers even now, quiet and insidious. They will grow ever stronger. His demands will become screams that drown out all else.
Well, it looks like we gotta find some, like, protection for our ears. Do they have something like that in this day and age?
In showing mercy, you showed weakness. When you spoke to Kayla Argent, you sought diplomacy, an end to the damage wrought across the land. Do you think your enemies understand compassion? Do you think they care for the greater good?
Compassion and strength aren't incompatible. I will help as many people as I can. That doesn't make me weak.
Oh? And yet you free a priestess of Bhaal, a mad murderess, on only her word that she would obey your directive. You show both weakness and stunning optimism.
He's seeing everything we're doing.
You must know by now that nothing you do escapes my sight.
Yeah.
I know your past. I watch your present. Thus, I know your future. It was written in your blood long ago.
Who are you who knows so much of my blood?
A man of singular knowledge, power, and purpose. All else is irrelevant.
I'll determine what is and is not irrelevant, mister.
You are not like the sheep you walk amongst. They distract you with their bleating whine. You have a purpose far beyond theirs, if you have strength enough to grasp it.
And who determines if I have strength enough? I guess just you?
Most go about their days unawares, blind to the truths around them, pushed and pulled by forces beyond their understanding. Control is what sets us apart from the animals scrabbling through the dirt.
If you say so.
We must be masters of our lives, of whatever resources we have to bear, bending them to our will. You will learn this in time.
Well, thanks for the advice, Mr. Hooded Man. But, I have no more clue as to who you are or what the hell you want. You want me to take control of everybody, apparently.
Kayla Argent has but the tiniest portion of divine essence. Yet she has boldly claimed her birthright and taken control of her destiny. You have half a god flowing through your veins, and yet you stumble your way toward your destiny as if blind.
Well, hey, no judgment or anything, right?
Spread your wings. Feel their power. Let this test you. If you are lucky, if you do well, further tests will come. Perhaps, eventually, you will learn what you need to soar.
I am not interested in any of your tests. Or any other tests. Begone with you. I had a vision of Bhaal's death. Get back here. Is that under appointment? No. As I crossed Boroskir Bridge, I was stricken with a vision of my father's death. I came to lying on the bridge with the eyes of my allies upon me. This may cause trouble for me down the road if rumors of my parentage spread among the Coalition. Alright. So it's a done quest. Disturbing implications. I should keep watch for another appearance of the Hooded Man. Once again, I encountered the strange Hooded Man. I blacked out while crossing Boroskir Bridge and awoke lying in a scorched symbol of Bhaal. The Hooded Man claimed to have saved my life and said my power can be contained or extracted. He also warned me that Kalar was not what she seemed. That much I had suspected. Okay. A mammoth statue of Cyric stands at the north end of Boroskir Bridge. His arm is outstretched, reaching for the giant stone figure that glares accusingly at him from the bridge's southern side. Oh. Is there a statue of Bhaal over here? Oh. For some reason I didn't even realize that. This towering statue of Bhaal, the dead lord of murder, glares across the length of Boroskir Bridge at an equally imposing stone likeness of Cyric, the mad god that killed him. That was a pretty awesome vision, and an interesting dialogue with the Hooded Man. We're close past the explosive barrels.
What you looking at?
Who's that? Oh, Kava.
Hold a minute. I want to talk to you. Farl and I got our loot out of the fort. Here's a little something for helping us out. We're moving on now. Maybe we'll cross paths again someday.
Thanks, Kava.
Bye.
300 gold. That's it? I finished my dealings with the half-orc irregulars. I helped the irregulars out, and Kava gave me a small reward as thanks. Even in the middle of war, I'm still attracting misfits and loners to my side. Yes, we're the Island of Misfit Toys. Well, not the island, but I guess the Brigade of Misfit Toys. We get just a tiny bit on this side. That's a rabbit. There may or may not be anything to see on this side. A wooden bucket swings from a rope tied around the old well's winch. Oh. Cool. Throw in 100 gold pieces. The wooden bucket sways in the breeze. Oh, it heals us? Okay.
What is it?
Then give us spells back.
What? Yes.
Put an item in the well. By using the winch, the bucket, and anything it holds can be lowered into the well. Huh? Do I dare do this? Would it make something magical? What if I put the void sword in there? The well spirit says, ouch. Did you throw a weapon at me? Is this a challenge? It was an accident, I assure you. I only wanted to see what would happen. No more words. Your trespass must be punished. Really? I wanted you to bless the well sword.
Huh?
I mean the void sword.
I shall give. Resisting me. Need to try something else.
No effect.
Fall down now.
I need a bigger sword.
McKin, Thaco modification. We really don't have spells and stuff right now. Well, really anything.
By demand. Resisting me.
Need to try
something else.
Yes.
Hells, I missed.
No effect. I need a bigger sword.
It's harmed only by magic, apparently.
Need to try something else.
We did get a special battle axe. Battle axe plus one. We need to sell this stuff. Let's identify the quarterstaff. Staff spear plus two. When this seemingly ordinary quarterstaff is examined magically, it has an aura of alteration. Upon command, a long, sharp spear blade will shoot forth from its upper end, making the staff into a spear. Likely made by a wizard or priest hoping to increase their melee capabilities, it is usable by anybody capable of handling a staff. 1d8 plus 3, piercing. Yeah. Well, the people that would use staves are wizards, and I don't want them getting into melee range, so. So if I... Did we lose the... Do we lose that?
Such menial tasks. Mm.
Trouble? Let's talk more fight!
Wait, hold on. We have that here, okay. Nothing happens. Okay. So nothing happened to it, right? It looks the same. Same negative one strength, 1d8 plus 3. Yeah, okay. Well, that was interesting. Oh.
Aye.
Oh, a pheasant. I'm like, that's colorful. Cool. Oh, we really can't advance into these woods. What was that? But just the sounds of battle. Let's just get by the water here. I mean, it's probably nothing. I just want to peel back the fog of war a little bit more. Oh, there's something here with this rock. Good thing we looked. Surprised I missed that, actually. Okay. We got a blue stone necklace and a studded necklace with Zio's gems. We have, like, no spells left. Let's see if we can rest. Okay, good.
Let's talk more fight!
Is this where we're going? Traveling hours? 336 to the Coalition camp? We never got to go to this. Well, I guess this is, Bridgefort. Though it looks like we never, like, went to it. Coalition camp 336.
Sword fight! The Crusade's recent presence can be seen on the road to Dragonspear Castle. But the Shining Lady's actual servants are rarely encountered. The few Crusaders you spy in the distance invariably retreat at the first opportunity. As the march wears on, fatigue grips your company, tempers flare within the caravan. Your reputation as the hero of Baldur's Gate protects you from petty squabbles and angry outbursts. Or perhaps, after what happened on Boriskir Bridge, there is another reason few are willing to cross you. These thoughts are put aside when you see the banners of Waterdeep, Daggerford, and the Flaming Fist at the edge of the Coalition siege camp. Dragonspear Castle is near, and so is Kalar's Day of Reckoning.
Why does she still refuse me? How can she deny the righteousness of our cause?
She's pacing.
We speak of a child of Bhaal.
That's, like, fast pacing.
And yet the Bhaal spawn is the hero of Baldur's Gate, and by all accounts saved the Sword Coast from ruin during the Iron Crisis.
That's right.
You cannot ask me to show mercy to this abomination. Not after what happened to my brother.
For the good of the Crusade, you must. We cannot take the Bhaal spawn's life.
Forgive I can't argue
me,
with
lady.
That.
I do not know if I can do that.
You can. I have faith in you, Ashatil. For us, forgiveness must prevail over revenge.
I don't mind not being killed. The Bridgefort siege has ended, thanks to me and my companions. I met several potential allies while defending Bridgefort, some more trustworthy than others. I had to decide who should join me in my quest. I think I made the best decisions possible. Yeah, all my allies at this can be found at the siege camp outside Dragonspear Castle if they're not currently in my party.
Finally, you're here.
Marshal Netherlock. I was just about to say the same thing. I'm Sapphire, and you are?
I'm Kirill Netherlock, Marshal of the Burntstone Cadre. I command the Flaming Fist contingent of the Dragonspear campaign.
Good to meet you, Marshal. I'm sure you and your party haven't had it easy these past weeks. I hope our arrival will turn the tide somewhat.
Enough bootlicking. This idiot owes you his thanks, not the other way around.
Well, I'm trying to be diplomatic over here, Viconia. What do you want from me?
I should warn you, don't expect a warm reception here. Word of what happened at Borskir Bridge spread like wildfire. Many in this camp, too many, see you as Saravok's heir apparent.
Well, don't worry. I don't have a lot of warm feelings among some of my companions either. Of course they do. Why wouldn't they? I only risked my life to save the entire Sword Coast from his diabolical machinations.
If anyone gives you trouble, report it to me. I'll take care of it.
McKin says, Sapphire does good taking care of her own troubles.
Is that a goblin?
A goblin? Where? Oh, you're talking about McKin? Yeah, she's a goblin. She's with me.
The gossip's tongues will fall off before tomorrow dawns.
Good.
Do what you can to keep a low profile, for all your sakes.
I'll do what I can.
Go get settled in now. After you've done that, come see me and the other city commanders at the large tent south of here.
McKin's presence is not entirely welcome in camp. We've reached the Coalition forces camp. Marshal Netterlock of the Flaming Fist is concerned about McKin's presence. I must keep a close eye on her and ensure she's not interfered with. Okay, there are a lot of people arriving here. Coalition sentry?
Such menial tasks.
Still, we wait.
Well met, hero.
We'll show the crusade, right?
A well-supplied camp keeps troop morale high.
Lots of work to do.
Well, we put all the prisoners if this crusade surrenders. To the sword, I say. Put them to the sword.
Yes, Corwin.
What do you need?
For the moment, nothing.
Lots of work to do.
Some say you're a hero. I say soldiers who do their own laundry are the real heroes.
Refugees!
Keep us safe.
This battle will be one for the history books.
Yes, let's talk more fight!
Oh, wait, we should all stay together. Oh, there's some people over here. Let's talk to Sergeant Wilch. I suppose these people don't say much.
We're more than mercenaries.
I have more important things to do than talk to you. I wouldn't want to talk to you even if I didn't. Okay.
We're more than mercenaries.
Good to see Captain Corwin here. She's a good officer. Won't be long before she's running the fist herself. Yeah, she's a good one.
Order is what matters.
Hurry up and wait. As we say in the fist. I mean, if I had room in my party, I'd have her join us, but I really don't want to trade out any of these people. I mean, if Corwin was a thief, she'd be a shoo-in to replace Safana, but otherwise, I really like our party the way it is right now.
We're few, but fierce.
It's the hero of Baldur's Gate. Pass, friend.
We're few, but fierce.
Same. Few, but fierce.
Still, we wait.
We're few, but fierce.
Beware the crusade. They're sneaky little buggers. And enthusiastic. I hear the horsey. Waterdeepian soldier?
for Waterdeep.
It's an honor to meet you, ma'am.
A pleasure it is to meet you.
Greetings, ma'am.
Still, we wait.
We Waterdeepians know how to get the job done. Oh, wait, we got a box. It's a box, man. A crate. Oh, arrow plus one. I'll take that for her.
I do not like the way our allies look at me.
I think McKinn has more to worry about. Proudly emblazoned upon this banner is Baldur's Gate's coat of arms, a mighty ship with blue skies above and darker waters below. A clenched fist, wreathed in fire upon a striking purple background, represents the troops the flaming fist of Baldur's Gate have committed to the siege of Dragonspear. Alright, so we got these other soldiers here.
I need a swig of some strong dwarven ale.
The Flaming Fist is a bunch of thugs from a city of thugs. We don't need them here.
Good day, and hello to you.
So, Waterdeepian, are these people from Waterdeep? She says that too.
Good day, and hello to you.
Oh, I guess so, yeah. Have you ever been to Waterdeep? A grand city. Someone like you wouldn't last a day. Thanks. Interestingly enough, the first Eye of the Beholder game takes place in Waterdeep. And I'm not sure. I think Waterdeep shows up in the other two games, at least where Kelvin Blackstaff comes from, in the second game. And then I'm not sure as far as... I'm talking about Eye of the Beholder 1 and 2. I'm not sure if I said Baldur's Gate at some point. Instead. Eye of the Beholder 3. I'm not sure where the heroes were gathered in the beginning. But I think it might have been somewhere other than Waterdeep.
Still, we wait.
I'll kill for a dinner from the friendly flounder right about now.
I need a swig of some strong dwarven ale.
Torsen Delancey knows what he's doing. He'll push Kalar's rabble back to Dragonspear and snuff them out for good.
I don't know. How much longer should we keep going? Let's talk to Belagarm. Looks like a merchant.
I have many fine wares.
Oh, it's you. Do you need something? We need to sell stuff. That's what we need to do. Soul of Troll Decapitation plus one. Did we get this at some point? Runes along the length of this powerful blade spell death to trolls in multiple languages. A green gem set in the weapon's hilt glows with a pale green light. Legend tells that the famous dwarf Durlag Troll Killer used this sword in his adventuring days, but lost it during a particularly brutal fight in the Troll Hills. Despite the item's name, it does not actually decapitate trolls. A rumor sprung up regarding its powers, and despite evidence to the contrary, the sword has never shaken the nickname. On a critical hit against a troll, the wearer gains plus one to strength for one turn. Non-cumulative. Plus one, plus three versus trolls. Alright, let's see. I am just going to sell the Void Sword. I'm not going to use it. I don't like the minus one to strength. He's good enough with what he has. So these two necklaces that we just found under that rock. Oh. And a lot of stuff in here. I'll probably just hold on to that. All these plus one things. Full plate. Oh, this would have been great against... Oh, you know what? You'd think it would have cold abilities. Oh, it has plus one cold. That's not that great. I mean, it might have been a little helpful against those fire elementals, but... Staff spear. Okay.
An army marches on its stomach.
Do I need a bunch more of these things? He doesn't have the special ones, the extra healing. Sounded like a lot of cursing. Seven, six, five, seven, and seven.
I have many fine wares.
Okay.
You want Boo?
No, I want to see who this guy is. Theard? Is that the one who...
I need a swig of some strong dwarven ale.
Yeah, he's the one who says you can rest in there. Vigilant Halasan. By the left. Quick march. Halt.
What a bunch of pathetic babies! I've never seen a worse lot in my entire career!